I'm Joshua Bardwell, and you're going to learn something today. A little while back, I announced my very first branded product, and it wasn't a new motor or a new flight controller, no. When I sit up at night dreaming about ways to make the world of FPV better, I dream about parallel charge boards. Ooh, psychoanalyze that, if you like. But as good as that product was, as soon as I got it, I immediately started thinking of ways to make it better. Yes, I nitpick my own products just as hard as I nitpick everybody else's. And that's why I'm really pleased to be here today to announce the release of version 2 of my parallel charge board. Stay tuned, I'm going to tell you all about it. If you know me, you know that I have a tendency to go on and on about every little thought that goes through my mind, and sometimes to a fault, I do admit. Many of you watch my videos on fast forward, I know. And I'm not going to do that today. I want to focus in this video on the ways in which the V2 board has been improved, and I'm going to resist the temptation to tell you all about the things that we did in the design process for the V1 board. You can go ahead back and watch the original announcement video for the V1 board if you want to know about that stuff. So if you didn't see that and you're wondering, like, why are there only 4S plugs on this? Why didn't we include the others? That's all in the original video. Link in the video description, and in the upper right, there's the card, the little eye symbol that you can tap or click. You can go watch that video. There were two main things I didn't like about the V1 board. And the first one was that the layout was a little bit cramped. It was really hard to plug the balance leads in, especially if you had really short balance leads. It was hard to kind of get your fingers down in there. It was a little too easy to plug the balance leads in incorrectly. And it was a little easy for them to get tugged by the battery and maybe accidentally get unplugged, especially, again, if you had very short balance leads. The other thing is that the batteries all kind of ended up just piled on top of each other. They didn't lay down nicely on the table. And again, it was a little bit of a risk that something would get unplugged. And we had some people who plugged their balance leads in wrong, and they burns the trace on the board and just basically destroys the board. And that's $25 out the window. That's no good. On the V2, we've given a little more spacing between the balance plugs, and we've moved the balance ports to the outside of the board so that the batteries can more easily lay flat. So you can see it's really easy for me to get in here and plug in, and then it's really easy for me to get my fingers in here. Just no problem. There's plenty of room to get your fingers in there and plug it in, and then the battery will nicely lay flat. You can easily plug in all 10 batteries and just have them laying out to the side. Very nice there. So that's a big improvement. The other thing that we've done is we've added polyfuses to protect the balance ports on the board. So the V1 board had automotive fuses on the main XT60 connectors, and the purpose of that was that, like, if you were to plug in a fully charged battery with a discharged battery, or you were to plug in, like, accidentally a 4S and a 3S together, a current would flow and it would pop the fuse and it would protect you from, well, the battery blowing up, and that's good. Then you just go and you replace the fuse and you're good to go. But the balance ports weren't protected. And so if you were to do that same thing, but you were to plug in the balance connector instead of the XT60, what would happen is that the trace on the board would burn out, and now your $25 board is basically ruined. Polyfuses are super cool. Now, when they pop, you don't replace them. They actually just auto reset. What happens is that current flows, it makes the polyfuse get super hot, and then the polyfuse just sort of clamps down and stops letting the current flow. And then so how do you reset it then? When the polyfuse cools down, it automatically resets. So this is great because it means that if you make a dumb mistake, like accidentally plugging in your balance lead backwards or something, instead of ruining your board, nothing's going to happen. You'll be safe. You do have to pay a little bit of attention though. There's no obvious visual indicator that the polyfuse has popped. What you have to do is you have to just feel that it got super hot. You still have to be safe, you still have to pay attention, but it does mean that if you make one dumb mistake, you don't ruin your whole board, and that certainly is a good thing. Now, when we released the V1 board, people said, I'd sure like some polyfuses on the balance ports, and one of the responses was, it would make the board more expensive. And in fact, if you look at other boards out there with polyfuses on them, they are way more. They're like, some of them are $60 or $70. And so I was really pleased when we got these boards back from the manufacturer. And I said, well, how much are they going to be? And I winced. And he said, $28. It's not that much freaking more than the original board. So I'm really pleased to be able to offer you guys this additional protection. And at not that much more price than you would have paid for the V1 board. So, okay, what more could you possibly ask for, right? If you have 4S batteries to charge, this is the parallel charging board that you should buy. There's just, this is it. You wanted polyfuses? You got polyfuses. The layout was a little cramped. We fixed that. It's got this cool cell checker readout, right? It's got an XT60 connector, which is what most people have these days, but it comes with a little adapter here if you want banana plugs. And, oh, by the way, it comes with this cool sticker that you can't get anywhere else. Haha, pretty cool. And it's like $28. So it's the cheapest. I mean, it's not the cheapest parallel board you can buy. You could get a board that doesn't have all these great features and only has like 6 ports for like $15. Okay, but this one, dollars per port, dollars per feature, there's just no question in my mind that this is the best parallel charge board on the market. And if you're in the market for one, I hope you'll give it a look. Thanks for watching. Happy flying.